With Jurassic World Rebirth finally out, fans have had some mixed reactions towards the creature designs, such as the Quetzalcoatlus and Spinosaurus being changed drastically from previous counterparts. But one creature in particular has divided fans of the franchise, the horrible mutant monstrosity, D-Rex. D-Rex is far more divisive than even the Indominus Rex was. But what exactly is D-Rex? What kind of Frankenstein-like genetic cocktail did InGen cook up this time? To figure that out, let's break down its DNA and the real-life mutations that might explain its bizarre features. Now the D-Rex, or Distortus Rex, is described as a failed attempt from InGen to genetically modify a Tyrannosaurus Rex. At 26 feet tall, 47 feet long, and weighing approximately over 20,000 pounds, this movie monster really is larger than life. DNA fragments from other animals were carelessly spliced in, leading to this gargantuan, mostly quadrupedal beast with enlarged legs, an extra pair of arms, a mouthful of mismatched teeth, and an engorged head it can barely support. To make matters worse, the D-Rex we see in the films is labeled as V26.7, which means at least 25 other failed versions led up to its creation. And if that wasn't enough, the average cost for an engineered species was over $72 million per clone. Looks like InGen really spared no expense, and things still went wrong. Given the large size and awkward anatomy of the Distortus Rex, this creature would likely have difficulty to hunt down larger prey on its own. It probably relies on scavenging off of corpses, or it opts to attack older individuals of animals. In addition, D-Rex likely lets the island's apex predators like T-Rex do all the hunting, and then uses its large size to scare off the hunters from their kills. D-Rex can also supplement its diet by picking up smaller animals like raptors to eat, and even humans who stumble upon the island. So, now that we have gotten familiar with this monster, let's speculate on what went into the DNA of this beast to make it look the way it does. For starters, we can assume that fragmented Tyrannosaurus Rex DNA was used as the base. But since no complete genome was available, InGen had to fill in the gaps with various other species, some of which could explain the D-Rex's monstrous appearance. Furthermore, because the initial DNA was so fragmentary, this could have increased the likelihood of negative mutations. One thing about the skull shape that stands out is how it appears to be smaller and more shortened and widened than any of the T-Rexes we see in the films. This could be due to a disorder known as brachycephaly, the same disorder that gives pugs their squashed-looking heads. In addition to T-Rex DNA, the large size of Distortus Rex could be attributed to DNA from the InGen Titanosaurus. Given that these InGen sauropods are much larger than their real-life counterparts, the inclusion of Titanosaurus DNA would have helped D-Rex reach his gargantuan size. One of D-Rex's most striking features is its additional set of forelimbs. In the real world, extra limbs in vertebrates can result from polymelia, a rare congenital condition that has been observed in animals including chickens, cows, reptiles, and amphibians. Given InGen's history of using frog DNA to patch up missing sequences, it's likely the disorder stems from this genetic source. But what if the extra arms weren't just a mutation? After all, polymelia alone doesn't lead to fully functional limbs, but the extra limbs that D-Rex has are clearly capable, as it uses these arms to help knuckle walk and even grab prey items. Now, there are no dinosaurs that we know of that could knuckle walk or even had arms remotely similar to D-Rex's extra set. But there is a group of prehistoric mammals that did have arms kind of like this, calicotheres. In that case, InGen may have intentionally or unintentionally incorporated DNA from calicotheres like a Mutadon, a bizarre prehistoric mammal with long, powerful forearm limbs adapted for grasping. While not a dinosaur, its knuckle-walking posture and three fingers equipped with sharp, sloth-like claws could have been used to enhance D-Rex's ability to knuckle walk and even manipulate and grab objects. Another rather unsettling trait of the D-Rex is its large, swollen, bulbous mass on its head. This could be influenced by DNA from bulbous-headed goldfish like the Oronda. Another possibility is hydrocephalus, a rare medical condition where excess cerebrospinal fluid causes swelling in the brain and skull. This could also explain why the D-Rex skull is so much wider compared to the T-Rexes that we see in the films. Since InGen's genetic modifications weren't perfectly stable, they may have accidentally triggered this disorder, leading to D-Rex's grotesque head shape. This would have also led to immense pain for the animal, including immense chronic headaches and discomfort. The D-Rex scaly skin has yellow-brown coloration, and its integument overall is not too different from its T-Rex counterparts. In fact, both the InGen T-Rex and D-Rex even have pronounced feature scales on its bottom jaws. DNA from certain color morphs of green iguanas is likely what helped contribute to the coloration and feature scales, and could also explain some of the striping we see on the D-Rex's body. While T-Rex was already a formidable predator, Distortus Rex seems to be on another level of hostility. InGen could have introduced DNA from saltwater crocodiles, known for their territorial nature and extreme aggression. The addition of saltwater crocodile DNA could also explain the teeth of Distortus Rex. Unlike the Tyrannosaurus Rex with large banana-sized serrated teeth, the D-Rex has a mismatch of stout interlocking teeth more akin to crocodilians than tyrannosaurs. And given all the possible genetic disorders and mutations that this animal may have been born with, it's highly likely that the heightened aggression is a result of an existence filled with never-ending pain and suffering. In the real world, many domestic animals and animals in captivity suffer due to genetic disorders and even gene splicing. A genetically engineered monster like D-Rex would be subject to a life of suffering and physical torment beyond its control, leading it to lash out. So, there we have it, our speculative breakdown of the genetic makeup of Jurassic World's D-Rex. Again, none of this is officially canon to the franchise. This is just a fun way to explore the science, or rather pseudoscience, behind these fictional hybrids. Let me know in the comments what you guys think went into this monster's genetic code, and what other mutations could have caused its grotesque appearance. And when you're done, consider watching this video about the Mutadons. Alongside the D-Rex, these bizarre winged hybrids are another neglected InGen monstrosity that call Ile Saint Hubert home. While not as large as the D-Rex, the Mutadons are just as terrifying and bizarre. As always, thank you for watching.